Hello guys, and welcome to another tutorial. And in this tutorial we are going to begin with making a building system like in Rust. First I want to do in one part of the series a little bit more, but it seems like it will take a half an hour, so we'll split it in two tutorials, so it will take a little bit longer. But first I've got here the from the standard assets from prototyping a prefab, and I just put it down in empty and remove the collider and add here and change the scale to 0.2 here, and also add a new material. We have got two materials. We're not going to use it this tutorial, I will explain it next tutorial, but we got two tutorials, a preview of green and preview of red. And that's with a new shader, and I will put a download link in the description. Just create shader, change it to Unlit alpha with fade, open it and copy paste everything. And after that, add to the empty game object here a box collider, send it to is trigger, and set the size to this. Also make it a little bit smaller, and that's also for the next tutorial, but it's important you already got it here. And also change the rigid body to this with these variables, and change the layer to build preview, and that's very important. And then also add a first person controller also from the standard assets. I didn't change anything of it, and only add a building system to it, the script, and that will stand within the scripts folder. And within just create a new script calling building system. I already created one. Here, the first line, we're going to use a list, so just put this list here. And well, let's begin. So we need a list of all the build objects, and we also need a build object from the current. So first, what needs to stand in that class? The first thing is of course the name, and it's a string. The second thing we are going to use this tutorial is the preview, and the third thing is how much it costs. We are not going to use this in this tutorial, maybe in another part of this tutorial, but not in this part. So the first thing is a list of all the build objects, and we call it objects, and it is a new list. And also we are going to have a current object and build object current object, so we can have the current object just always ready. And then we're going to make so first we're going to need to change the current building, or change the current object of preview, or whatever you want to call it. And in that, it will instantiate a new game object. So game object currentpref, and it will instantiate something, and after that it will be as a game object, and it will assign to this variable, and this will be from the current object, of course, the preview. And also we need a position and we need a rotation. So the rotation, we are not going to change that in this part of the tutorial, so just change that to this. Identity. And yeah. And we need a position, so we're just going to create a private factor 3 of the current position, and we will change the current position through the whole script, but that will be, I will say how to do that later on in this part of the tutorial. And in the current preview and we also need a public transform to see the current preview, so that you will get the current the transform of the current preview, and you can change the location, the rotation, the well, everything from it, just within the script. So the current preview is the transform of the game object we just instantiated, and also, yeah, that's everything. And that the first at first we're going to call it in the start function, and that's the first time we are going to call it. And first we change the current object to objects, and objects, and to the first one of it, and then we're going to call this one. And also we set cursor to invisible, and also we lock the cursor, and normally I do this within another script, but because we're not going to create that script, I'm not going to I put it in here. And then also it needs to start preview, so you will actually see an object in the scene itself. So we're going to start it within this void, and first it will send a raycast from where it has to be. So raycast, and so we need some variables for that, and the first one is from where it will be, the from where the raycast will start, and that's the camera. So add that, and also you need a raycast hit for the output. So raycast hit hit, and change this to and now we're going to assign all those variables. Also another one before I forgot it is a layer mask, and that's are all the layers that the raycast can actually find in the raycast itself. So it will start from the camera position, it will go forward, that's the direction of the from which it will be, and the output is the hit, and it will have a distance of 10, and it will only affect the layers we assigned there, or we are going to assign later on. And then we are going to check, is the hit this hit? If it isn't, then we're going to go to the next step of assigning the place where the preview will be. So we're going to do that in another void, and we are going to call that show preview. And we need, at first we need the location and the position and everything from the hit itself. So raycast hit hit 2, and here we are going to call it, so it will go to this void, and here we are going to assign change the current position to the point where it hits the raycast hit the ground. And we are now going to snap it to the grid, and we are going to do this with a public float offset. And I just got this how to do this from the Unity answer, so it's so we're just going to copy it and to snap this to the grid, and you're going to do this right with like this. Just copy this, I will put it in the description, and also the current preview, so that's the game object, it's actually in the scene, and from that the position will be the current position. So now we're going to change something right here. So we are going to put this prefabs in a new folder, rust prefabs, and here we have the script, and we are going to add one object to the objects, and we are going to call it foundation. The preview is, of course, this one, and well, called, we don't going to use it now, but that's 50. And the camera is this one, and it will get every layer except for the build preview. Well, let me just show you if I didn't did anything. Then it will look like this. Oh, sorry, I've got one thing in the script, and that is the update, because every update it needs to be the preview needs to be changed, and that is only if a new variable public bool is building. So just to make sure you are actually building, and if you aren't, then nothing will happen, and then it will start preview. And if we again, I've got something. We need to change this to is building. But now, if you are going to walk around and you show it everywhere, we get this weird glitch, and that's where this thing will be. So if you uncheck build preview, and now you look around, everything works fine, and well, I think that's awesome. The thing is, you still can't build or anything like that. That will be in the next part of the tutorial. So this is all for this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please leave a like or a subscribe. And if you've got any questions, please put it in the comment section below. And I see you guys next week.